Hi, I'm Randy Barnett for Fluke, and with 35 years of experience as an electrician, I've ended up as a power quality expert and electrical trainer. And in this video, I'd like to talk to you about your electricity bill. Right now, maybe you just would like to reduce it, and all you really know is how much you have to pay every month for electricity. What you really need to know is, where does all that electricity go? And if you're going to determine that, you need to measure some values. Some information like your total energy consumption in your facility, power factor, and peak demand. Some of the energy logging steps we will take today to help you streamline your energy consumption are: identify large loads, log at service entrance and log each large load, compare log data to the utility bill and address the issues that are revealed, review your kilowatt hours, peak demand, and power factor charges. You are charged for your demand usage in addition to the kilowatt hours. Demand is the amount of electricity used over a period. Power factor reflects how efficient you are with the electricity supplied. As you can see, the Fluke 1735 power logger collects the same data that you saw on your power bill. The top half of the power logger screen shows demand, or kW. The next screen shows kilovolt amps, or kVA, on the bottom. The corresponding MVA value is shown at the top. The next screen shows the kilovolt amps reactive, or kVARs, and on the next screen, power factor is shown, the key parameter we are trying to maintain. Now, let's talk about where to log. I recommend using a one-line diagram to visualize your plant distribution system. Your job is to find the loads drawing the most power. Log power at or close to the service entrance at a safe location. Always make sure of the nominal system voltage before going into a panel. You want to capture the full demand cycle if at all possible. In particular, we want to use less energy at times when it's the most expensive. But we also want to see how much we're drawing during the middle of the night to see if there are things we could shut off and see what our power draw looks like when multiple loads are working simultaneously. Later on, we'll use this data to see if we can change our operation to use less energy. When you're done with all of your logging and you've downloaded your data from your power logger into your computer, sit down with your utility bill and your operating schedule for that same period. Here are some things you need to look for. Learning to manage peak demand and power factor are two of the quickest and easiest ways to save on your electric utility bill. By correctly analyzing the data from the Fluke 1735 power logger, you can determine the best time to operate large loads and where to add power factor correction capacitors. The result? Money saved. So now that you know how much electricity you're using every month and where all that electricity is going, you can start making some decisions in order to reduce that monthly electrical utility bill. You're going to have to record some data. Use the Fluke 435 Power Quality Analyzer and the Fluke 1735 Power Logger. Then you can analyze that data and, down the road, you can make some more intelligent load management decisions. For Fluke, I'm Randy Barnett.